Good morning and welcome back. Yes, you are the first. You're right. I'm still coughing a bit, and but apart from that, I'm fine. And thanks for the host, Chief 120. Yeah, I'm still a bit. Still have a sour throat and I'm coughing a bit, but apart from that, I'm fine. And how are you? Yeah, switched over last week, and I'm trying it out this week and see if I can get the base mechanics and all the things I am used to in from Unity in here. There are a few features in here that are either more comfortable to use or a lot cheaper to get. Let's call it that way. And another thing is that I have people helping me, or people, my brother helping me with my characters, and he likes to do it in Unreal and not in Unity, because Unity, the system I was using, Yuma, was a bit strange. And he couldn't really work with it to create characters. And here he knows how to get characters in the game, give me different options for my character creation, and then I have the shader editor that I can work with for the terrain materials. That can be really nice, really nice optical results, and blueprint scripting. All that stuff. It's has nothing to do with if any of the engines are better or worse. It's just a matter of working with other people and trying to help other people out, stuff like that. If I find something that is really, let's call it game stopping, something that blocks me from going further, within this week, I might switch back over to Unity and continue working there. One of the aspects I don't really like about building stuff inside the Unreal Editor, like the houses I had, is the fact that I needed to move it over to into a blueprint. And in this blueprint and in the editor as well, I can't use vertex snapping. So I needed something, some environment where I could use proper coordinates, and couldn't really do that inside the editor here. Oh, why is it turning black? Because I couldn't create an empty parent object like I am used to in Unity. So that was a bit strange, but it works this way, so I can create all the stuff in a blueprint and then just compile it, and the changes will be represented here in the editor as well. So it's just something to get used to. And another aspect is that, like I said before, a lot of things are a bit, are not that expensive. Unity lives from getting stuff from the asset store to expand the base features Unity has. And Unreal has a different philosophy in that way. In Unreal, you have more of the idea that everyone is working and contributing to the same engine, so that the engine as a whole will get better. Yes, I could do that as well, yeah. But the thing is, I like to work with modular pieces where I can just, if I'm not sure about the layout here, I can change it in here quite quickly. And if I had this model only in an external 3D program, then I would need to switch over to that 3D program, make my changes there, import it back into the engine, and then have the have changes that way. But here, if I don't like this part here and just want to change it out to something different, I can do that without problem. That's why I like modular building and modular pieces. And building houses is kind of what I wanted to do today. And for that, I wanted to have a look at different layouts for villages and stuff like that on mountains, because I realized that in the Unity version or my earlier designs, I was building the village basically on a plane and didn't feel right. So I was thinking about building it more vertical, like in these pictures here. And this I just saved out of curiosity, because who would want to live under a mountain like that? It's really strange. I like this one. The elevation changes here and stuff like that, it's really awesome. You mean this one here? It's the only hard thing to build here is to have the assets for it. The problem I have at the moment is that I don't have assets that I can use in that angle. But I could rotate different buildings and put them next to each other and then could create that. And the elevation difference is no problem, I think. It's more like that the walls are bent in some ways. It looks like it. I mean, if I take this and use this as a base for something I could. Create different rotations here and then. Kind of set it up the same way. I mean, this is a specific layout for the building, but for one specific building, but if I take more generic approach with just a block, could just block out some of it. Yeah, you could use Bezier curves, that's right, but do you have to? That's kind of the thing. Is it really necessary? For instance, we could take this as a small building, then we can create a big building here. And then try to that out somehow. Let's move this one up here. So move some building over here. And here I have already a bit of elevation in the terrain, so let's use that. then we could also smooth out this area here. Kind of create a walkway up here. Let's see, do I have... Okay, I have a ramp brush, that's awesome. Ramp. Oh, okay. That's big. But that's another thing I just noticed. I was looking for a tool in Unity for adding ramps, and here it's included into the Unreal Editor. It's really awesome. And in Unity I would have to pay for something like this. Yeah, but I think you can change the gizmo size somewhere. So we can make this a bit smaller. Now we have this ramp going up there. One thing I want to... Can I use more than 2 points? That would be awesome. So, set a point here, set a point here, then set another point here. No, can only use 2 points. Okay. So let's add 1 point here and another point here. Nope. Reset. Start down here. Go up there. Yep. And here it took me ages to get a proper ramp in here with smooth tools and stuff like that. And when I was working in Unity. And here I have a ramp tool and can just click twice and press a button and I get a ramp. Awesome. And one thing I need to build in here is functionality that it will paint the terrain according to elevation and stuff like that. I already found a tutorial to do that, but I need to watch that tutorial and then implement it. I might do that this afternoon, maybe. Or evening. Or for the evening stream, maybe. That's what I wanted to say. Another thing is I need to figure out how many buildings I want to have in here and stuff like that. Because if I remember the Unity version has I'm not sure. No, it doesn't look like it. Not out of the box. Yeah, no, these are. But you can create a shader that does that. So it's up to you what you want to have. Yeah, the shade editor is awesome. This is the basic, really simple terrain material here. It's using layer blend for terrains. The problem is that doesn't really work 100%. Or at least it doesn't work with come on, open it. With this handy node here. This enables me to cut holes into the terrain. The problem is those two nodes, the layer blend and this visibility masks, don't really work well together, so I need to find a better setup for that. But what I can do is go over here where my cave is, and if it was working perfectly, I could just go in here and set this and cut a hole in here. But like I said, it's not working perfectly at the moment. So I'm getting this bug that since I cut out a piece there, all the textures are gone in this area here. But if I change this, there was a trick to do this. I'm not remembered 100%. Interesting. Doesn't want to have the other. Yeah, no, it doesn't. Ah, okay. Now all the terrain is gone. Damn it. Oh no, it's recompiling shaders. Okay. Let's see what it does. Didn't change anything. But if we go in here and wait for a moment, finish auto saving. And if we remove the... Yeah, now this visibility part is gone and we get the texture, the terrain textures back. So we need to change this material. Let's see. Let's do that. We have. Was it? Up here. Let's see. Change this a bit. Let's see. Get the diffuse here. Diffuse 2. And then we need the ambient occlusion of those 2, maybe. What do we have? Let's try if we can use this as a texture for them. Okay, we don't get the height map for that. The rock texture now. I had height map for this as well. Yes, I have. And we need it for this here. layout is a bit strange here, so let's move this over. Let's try this with just one height map. And let's remove this. Difference. And here I'm just playing around. I don't really know what this does, so how to configure it correctly so that works. I'm just playing around, see what we get. And here, this works now. Awesome. Play from here. We now cut out this terrain piece and can go in here. We could. No, we couldn't go in there earlier, but now we can and it looks awesome. Yay! Fixed that. Problem is we don't have our textures now, which we need to look at in a moment. It's the base standard Unreal thingy. So I haven't added my own stuff yet. And for that simple, it's called simple feature, I kind of paid $60 in Unity. So the contrast, you get same features, but you need to pay money for it. A lot of money sometimes. I mean, the shader system RTP does a lot more than just terrain holds, but I have a tutorial series that's about an hour long that lets me create the whole functionality that RTP has for free in Unreal, just with the shader editor. Why does this not work? It's a constant here. Ah, okay, now we have difference here in the texture. Let's apply that. I don't see the difference. Much. Yeah. The thing is, I started the project in Unity because I had worked in Unity before, basically, and didn't really think about using specific features. I just started doing a bit of level design and then kind of went from there. Nope. This out of the way so we can navigate here a bit better. For me, it was just familiarity with the engine. I knew how to work with Unity, and didn't want to start learning anything new at that point, so I started in Unity. And at some point I noticed, okay, I need help with some aspects. And then my brother said, okay, I try to help you. And he did try. Problem is, he couldn't get the same results in Unity as he got in Unreal. So we chose Unreal. At the moment I'm testing out if I can get stuff to work in here the way I want it. I think I will remove this big ramp here. Because I'm not sure what I would want to put up there. Then I could also add houses down here. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's kind of 3D mouse are you using? Sorry about that. This area here is where the barracks will be, so this makes sense if it's flattened out a bit. Grounds. And this is just a rough block out of what it will be at some point. In here as well. Basic layout of the towers. Yeah, let's move this tower down here a bit and then. Sorry about that. And in Unity, I didn't build complete walls around town, but I think I might do that here. Wall around here. Add a tower there. Oops, no, up here. So we need to move this. Forward. find another tower over here. Change this a bit here, so let's give this a bit more area here. Let's see. Sides of the road, and yeah, then we can move this over slightly. This area here. Kind of like the slightly flattened out area for the inn that I have here, so we'll keep that. But how do I want to proceed with the walls then? And are there buildings here? Another important aspect I need to think about is how do they get food? So where are farms, and how do they get to them and stuff like that? I mean, there's a huge lake over here, so That's a sauce of for fish and stuff like that. Fish and water, even though it's the water was turned into wine at some point, so it's kind of not really drinking water. So they need better source for water. In medieval times, definitely, yeah. This building here is a warehouse. It's a big warehouse that I have here, and then in front of the warehouse is the market square. So that's kind of the area where the food is distributed, but it has to come from somewhere and not too far away. And I need that, yes, right. Is that something you grow in a field? I'm sadly absolutely not familiar with that. Yes, I am not drinking beer myself. And I have no idea how it is correctly made. That's something I need to look up. Okay, it's like wheat. Okay, that's good to know. But the thing is, the town gets the beer from the brewery, which is way over here. So that leaves us in enough space for big fields, farms and stuff like that over here. So this area here we can use for farms. So it's not that much of a problem. But why is that town here and yeah, I mean, okay, it gets all the stuff from a road that goes along here, and the town is there because because it's an old dwarven brewery that was located over there. It's kind of the layout I got from the campaign I played with friends. And I didn't create the campaign, I didn't run the campaign. I'm just using the world that was created there. And by campaign, I mean Dungeons and Dragons. I mean, there could be some kind of manufacturing thing in here in town. That's not much of a problem there. We already have in the old layout I already have a smithy that was located here somewhere. So we can expand that to at what are they called? Glass blowers? I don't know. and all the other stuff. But we also have a kind of empty area in front of town over here, so we could also add fields in here. Something I was thinking about at some point. Just add fields. Because it's kind of a huge area as well. Yep. And like I said, that could be in town. Blacksmith here. Other manufacturing here. That's the town in here. Yeah, we could create some kind of damn it, what is it called? Not merchant. I know the German word for it, but manufacturing, people building stuff, and so living in a specific area of town. Damn it. What's the word? No, not the marketplace. But it could be near the marketplace. Yeah, workers, but is it called workers' quarters or workers' thing like that in towns? I don't know. Let's have a look at our handy pictures here. Maybe we have some with annotations. Oh. Sorry about that. I can just look it up, you're right. Craftsman. Yeah, craftsman area, craftsman district, or crafts district. That's what I was looking for. And that's something that could be around here. Miss, then near that, what did you call it? Cooper? To make barrels. us more into town. They could have them kind of in the square here. There would be that, even though I'm not sure if it would be in town. Because the town is more of a mining town, and we have the mine over here. Here we have the mine. Oh, there will be the mine. And then we have the other thing is the brewery is on the other side of the world, basically. But you don't need barrels just for beer. You need them for all other different things, and I would think you also would make buckets and stuff like that. So to have them in town would be okay. The brewery is over here, in this area here. And it won't just be one building for the brewery. There will be side buildings for craftsmen and stuff like that. But it's mostly abandoned. So let's take out these. Terraces here, because I don't like those. And the brewery was, like I said, was abandoned and just recently got a new owner and reopened. Because the characters that played in the D&D campaign kind of took over the brewery, and you will be able to meet them if I'm able to recreate all the characters in game. And here we will have the brewery, so let's get a big building and just throw that in here. Somewhere. And then a few small side buildings. And this will also get walls around it. This area. Not that big. Let's rotate this in a bit. Yeah, and then move it forward. So we have the entrance here. Then we have side buildings somewhere here. And the walls around here will not be as big and imposing as the walls around town. Might be simple wooden palisades. I'm not sure if the right words. Simply wooden walls around this. This would be the brewery. Main building and two or maybe one or two more side buildings. Though most of them will be kind of run down. And the walls will be quite simple and recently built. Yeah, there will definitely be chimneys, yes. That's just a simple block out for the moment. So that's where the brewery is. That's on the other side of the world, basically. That robot? The brewery? It's like a sad robot. Sorry about that, yeah. Hello, how are you? Yeah, I'm still a bit ill. Sorry about the coughing. Still need to think about this area in the middle of town because it's a bit too open. Yeah, I kind of know what's going on there. In my break later, I have to go to the drugstore and get some medication. So it's not much of a problem. And it's simple cold thingy, nothing too major. Yeah, I noticed the name, I remembered. I'm working on an exploration adventure game, and it's kind of open worldy walking simulator esque, let's call it that. Let me save all this, and then I can show you the prototype I have for the game that I built in Unity. Hopefully this will not kill my stream. Let's create a new game. You can create your character. Male, female, elven. Whatever you want. Let's create a guy. Oh. Still. Tim, since he's wearing armor, let's give him a bit of muscle. Not that much. And let's reduce the weight a bit. And make him bigger. Oh no, let's make him small. That's small, but buff. So let's play with that character. Yep. And there's a small issue here with triggering the right animations at the right time and switching the cameras, because he's supposed to, the camera is supposed to show him falling from the sky, and I just broke this for some reason. And let's clear all this and if we press J we open up the journal. And I still need to build the tutorial area and stuff like that. And if we look around here, oh, there's a guy over here waving at us. So we can talk to him for some reason. Yeah, okay, the collisions do not work properly here. Yeah, it started as that. It started as a map for role-playing session I had with friends, but not for the game itself, but based on that game. So I just wanted to add to create the map and kind of play with it. Yeah, I just threw in some random dates. And this guy tells us a bit about where we are and tells us, oh, there's a village not far from here, and kind of sends us on our way to explore this. And here we found an old temple which was kind of obscured in the background, and we talked to the guy. So if we run back in here, now you can see the temple with the floating, growing, glowing crystals up there. And annoying artifacts in the background. And if we look at this, there's also an indicator, okay, there's a village somewhere around here. But as you saw the other message here, if I left click it, I have not found that location yet, so I can not teleport to it basically. So let's run along the road and get into town. And that town that we get to is the one that I'm building at the moment, or blocking out in Unreal, because I need to completely recreate it. There's supposed to be a guard. And here we have the town. It's the inn. Dragon's Spine, named after the mountain in the background. Yeah, the thing is, there's a quest where you have to go to the brewery and back, and like you saw, the brewery is on the other end of the map, and you have to walk all the way back. And so far I haven't added any change of terrain or encounters on the map to give you something new when you walk the same way. Yeah, I haven't finished Skyrim yet. I have about 80, 90 hours or so in the game, and kind of stopped at some point. But that's another unrelated reason I stopped. Okay, let's talk to this guy. Oh no, the inn is closed. Why? They're out of beer. No. Okay. Ah. He sends us on quest to get to the brewery. You can finish the main story, but not sure if you can really finish Skyrim. Not sure. Okay, and now we have a quest. Yay! And we have an overarching quest that was we accepted some kind of contract, and in this case here we are trying to find a magical recipe for beer, the magic ale recipe. And we can also look at stuff. Right clicking gives us information. What we see basically, or a bit more information about some kind of text that's somewhere also. And left clicking is interacting with it. And here we have the market place. And as you can see, we are quite short. Can't even look that much over the counter. At the moment, we can't interact with anything here. But that's something I want to add in there, that you can interact with it and buy stuff. And here we have the fort with the barracks and some guards patrolling around. And a notice board where I will add notices about interesting things, rumors, and stuff like that happening in the world. And that lets you go out and explore. And we also have outstanding citizens. Those are just people that helped me with something in the stream for some reason. Or we're just here and be nice and friendly. And there's room for more names. And there's an old mine, but earlier we can't get there. Yep, you're on the board. Run around here. Yeah. the Nuffmesh navigation. And here we have the mine. This tool shed. Mine entrance, but there's nothing more in here at the moment. Can't open the door. Can't even interact with it. And here we have the village. And this is how we get back to the village if we want to. And here's another hint that there's something to explore, and that's signed to the troll cave. And then we have this bigger area here there where there's basically nothing, just out of town. I want to turn into farms. Or a farm, not sure. Then over here we have the fisherman's hut. Or house in this case. And this area here. And a lake in a strange color. And some graphical errors. Interesting. And we have this thing. It's supposed to be some kind of plaque that has text on it, but I didn't create the proper model. I just used pedestal I had somewhere flying around. But if we right-click it, then get a bit of information about the lake. Yeah, I was thinking about that. Another thing was to create some kind of not language, but some font that you can still read, and then you get if you hover over it, you get kind of a tooltip what it says. That way it wouldn't be plain English, and you still have a bit of immersion in that regard. Oh. This build has fish. Hello, fish. How are you? And why are some of you... Oh yeah, that's another thing I kind of tackled with and couldn't get rid of. Flying fish. Thing is, they have a... in this case, they didn't have enough mesh component on themselves, and using the whole terrain as their navigation mesh to hunt smaller fish. All these smaller fish are trying to find food. Not sure if we have some around here. Yeah, They mostly left the lake behind. So there might be upriver here somewhere. Yeah, they are over here somewhere. But I saw. Oh, there's a light over here. Have a look at this. Interesting. Oh, who's that guy? Oh, he's a troll. Okay. So this must be the troll cave. Oh yes, I'm definitely a troll. Okay. Sniff. Yeah, okay, we don't really look like a troll. Can we talk to him again? Yep. Ooh, nice. Old chest on top of the dragon spine. Ooh, interesting. Let's see. So we have this innkeeper quest. And now the troll gave us another quest. Awesome. But they are not really quests you can track like in an RPG. But oh, a lot of flying fish again. Awesome. Hello, fish. So let's see if we can find that chest. Oh, and there's a statue over here. Interesting. Knight of some kind. Maybe a king, I don't know. Let's see. Okay, Knights of the Way. Okay, what are those guys? Let's see, do we get some information of this? Oh, so they are some kind of misguided fanatics? No, I was talking to the other purple fish the one flying around in my world. I'm not sure. Is your name purple? Color? Okay, and now we are on the mountain, and this kind of looks like a spine. So let's walk along this. And we can also try to see a bit of the land, even though it's all foggy at the moment and we can't see really far. Okay, good to know. Okay, down there's the town. And somewhere over there's the brewery we go to next. But first, let's try to find this magical chest over here. See what the troll quest gets us. Around here. Strange. Yeah, it's something I haven't configured in this build yet. The sounds and the weather. It's always grey and foggy. I mean, Mint Arcade would feel like home here, I think. The only thing missing is rain. Oh, I think there's something over here. Didn't you say you were from England or Great Britain? The land of sunshine and tropical temperatures? But no, the chest is empty. Nothing in here. See, does the character say about that? Found an empty chest, nothing magic about it. Okay. So we got trolled. Yay! So, never trust a troll. Yes, that's what I meant. so let's run down here. Let's search of the brewery. The brewery. Thought it was around here somewhere. Oh, there it is. Yay, and we have a road again. Awesome. And this is the simple version of the brewery outside. And now we also have new journal entry here for the Steinhammer Brewery. Ah, the doors are locked. Damn it. All that for nothing. Oh wait, I think I saw someone around here. Yes, there's this guy. What are you? Oh. Does look very friendly. Goblin, maybe? No, no. The brewery is also closed. Damn it. Oh, okay. He's giving us the key. Thanks. We have the brewery key. Da da. Yippee. And we unlocked it, but for some reason the door doesn't open. But now we can. Sorry about that. Walk around in here. Let's see. What's upstairs? Okay, nothing we can interact with much. Okay. Let's go. Have a look around here. Wine. Barrels we can't interact with. Areas we can't walk through. It's over here. Okay. There's some issues with lighting in here. But those are trapdoors. And what could this area be if you see a lot of small rooms with trapdoors in it? What could that be? I mean, I just need to add some particle effects with flies flying around on top of them. It's a bit more obvious. Yep, that's what they are. Okay, the kitchen. nothing to interact with in here. Damn it. So, let's go downstairs. Yeah, let's go downstairs. Yep. Toilets. Oh, okay. That's quite obvious. Hmm. What could be in here? But there is some liquid in it, so that's good. And if you're lucky, it is beer. So let's take that. Is that... okay. Some arrows in here. Clear that. Okay, so... I know. I'm well aware of that. But this is fantasy, not really medieval times, so... there might be a few things different. Okay, do we want to run back to town, or... do we want to take this? Because this is... it's not readable. It will take us somewhere. So that's why I have the kind of fast travel or teleport system in here. So that we can get back to town more easily.